Hi everybody, this is Dr. Khushbu from Segan Mantras. Today we'll be talking about how to teach a child on the autism spectrum or with any neurological condition the correct usage of pronouns. So whenever we pick up any goal, like here our goal is that child should be using pronouns correctly, we need to have some things in place. So in this case, it will be nouns. The child should be confidently using nouns. He should understand the various categories like a person, place, animal, thing, because based on this, you will be using the pronouns later in the grammar also and in English language also, it will help you, not just in the spoken language. So also under person, the child should be confidently able to make the difference between girl and boy. Nahi to you'll get stuck with he, she, his, her a lot. So we need to work on that first. Once that is in place, we move ahead teaching the child how to replace that noun with the pronoun, and we play a few games to build that concept. So first one, and all this is nothing technical or from the theory. This is purely my experience, my learning, which I'm sharing with you. So the first game which you can play here is you pick up any category of people, say suppose community helpers we pick up here, and you would have a lot of, either in the books or in the chat papers, flashcards or some activity boxes in which you would have cards related to this. Or you can take a printout or draw some, sketches, a doctor with a stethoscope, a postman with an envelope in hand, whatever works for you and is easy for the child to understand as well. So you have 8 to 10 such cards, and now the child can differentiate between the boy and the girl, man and the woman. So you can actually take a board or a cardboard or a table, draw a line in the center, in the middle, write he and the male face. Now in your turn, rather you start with your turn, and it'll be a game with turns. So first you put all the cards inside a box or in a pouch or something. Now, first turn would be yours. You take out one card and place it under the correct column, he or she, and say, okay, hold on. Before we move to this, I would suggest let's do it with the nouns first. So what we'll do is round one, quick one we'll do. You take out the card and you just say doctor. The child takes out another card. He says postman. You take out teacher. The child takes out another card, says nurse. So this is round one where you're just testing whether he knows all of them, whether he's like thorough with the nouns or not. Once that is done, you can play round two. You can either play it immediately or maybe next day or after a while or so. Now here's what we have to do. In that board, you take out the card and instead of saying just the doctor, you would say he is a doctor and place it under he. Now in child's turn, suppose he gets the postman. So he is a postman. Emphasize on he and make the child place it under he. Then your turn. She is a teacher. Now teacher could be he or she. So whichever card you have. She is a nurse. Like that. So you have to play this game. Then another day you can maybe change things. You can have pictures of your family members, some friends, or any cutouts from the books, some story books, the cartoon characters, that ways. So you can, play around that. And the child gets confident with the use of he and she with repeated practice. Another game that you can play here is, now use of I and you in particular. So you take take some container or a big packet or pouch or something like that and place of miscellaneous objects in that. Objects ka koi yahan pe significance nahi hai. It's about who is taking it out. Because we want the child to learn I and you here. So suppose you pick out the first object and you say, I found a pen. Then child takes out something and he says, you have to help the child. Where's that doll gone? Not around. So you have to say, you have to take the child's hand, help him point to himself and say, I found a sharpener. Then place it out. Maybe you can, you know, make two separate bunches of items. So you keep things towards yourself, whatever you are taking out, and the child will keep on his side. So I found a torch. Then child takes out something and he says, I found a battery. So aise karke miscellaneous items, whatever things you find around, it could be even the waste items which you're not using anymore, and you can use it for this purpose. Because any which ways here, the what item is not going to make a lot of difference, make any difference here. So this way you do. And then in the end, wrap up the bag. The items are all out on the table. You have four or five items towards your side, and the child has equal number of items on his side. Now you ask questions. If the child doesn't understand questions, then maybe we can, you know, wait for some time to play this particular round. But otherwise, you can go ahead with this and ask, who found the torch? And then the child, if child it is on the child's side, you help him say, I found the torch. And then, who found the pen? The child, if you have to take the child's hand, point it to you and say, you found. Because now we are playing it from the child's side. You have to give him his use of language. So you don't have to say I. Otherwise, the child will get confused. Ki kabhi to I bolna padta hai, kabhi you bolna padta hai, kabhi mama I bolti hai, kabhi mama you bolti hai. So it is everything. Like all the talking is from the child's side. I found this. You found this. You are only asking the question. Who found this? Who found that? The child is answering with I and you correctly. Wherever he is going wrong, you correct him. So this is the second type of game. Third, what you can do is, in your daily routine, starting right from the morning, start labeling everything that the child is doing. I have woken up. I am going for a bath. I am having my breakfast. So whenever the child is doing that particular activity or a part of his routine, you have to help the child again, use his hand, make him point and make him say, or you say on his behalf, I am eating. Yeah, you have to like point child's hand on his chest and say, I am eating. Sorry. That way. So the entire day, the same thing goes on. He gets so used to hearing to that, I. Every time when they are using I, it's me. Gradually, when the I gets very strongly in his head, then you bring my in the picture. I, my, that all these go with the child for his own, you know, they are the pronouns for his own self. And one more game here. So suppose you take two sheets. On one sheet, you write your name in bold letters, and on the other sheet, the child's name. Now you decide on, let's say, alphabets only, or numbers to make it very simple. So turn by turn, you write one alphabet in your paper and you say it aloud. I wrote S. Then child writes, I wrote K. Whatever he's writing, you just help him say, I wrote so and so. I wrote R. Then your turn, then child's turn. So like this, say 5 or 10 alphabets you write, letters, and 5 or 10 letters the child writes. Again, now it's up to you whether you want him to read out loud. So jo aapka wala paper hai, in which your name is written on top as a heading, you write you if the child is reading. So the child has to read. पहले तो वो ये पढ़ता है मम्मा, मतलब अगर आप उससे डायरेक्टली ऐसे पूछोगे तो ही विल से मम्मा रोट दिस, बट नाउ यू हैव टू हेल्प हिम इन से इंस्टेड ऑफ मम्मा यू बोलना है. सो ही विल से यू रोट दिस, आई रोट दिस. पहले वो अपनी पूरी शीट पढ़ ले, आई रोट ए, आई रोट के, आई रोट एस, एंड देन यू रोट दिस, यू रोट दैट. और एल्स यू कैन अगेन डू इट विद द क्वेश्चंस. तो आपके पास जैसे इतना स्कोप. So now when you move to stories, you can either pick up a small storybook or pick up some reading comprehension passage from the worksheets available online, or you can create your own passage from some part of your routine, like the morning routine. You are cooking food, the husband is getting ready for office, the child is packing up his bag or getting ready for school. So maybe you can create a small passage around this with the use of nouns, pronouns, and then put up questions. Who was making food? Who dropped you to school? Who got, who burnt her finger in the kitchen? Aise karke. But frame your questions in such a way so that the answer has to come in the form of pronouns. And you can have some fill in the blanks, whatever level your child is at, like whatever type of questions he can comprehend, understand, and is able to answer. So this is how we move stepwise in building up this concept of pronouns. So hope this helps. All the very best. Thank you.